Hello and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In the previous video, I went over some of Clip Studio Paint's comic making materials. Today I'll be discussing auto actions and some ways to use them. Links to additional tutorials and information for everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description. So what exactly are auto actions? You can think of an auto action like a shortcut to complete a series of tasks really quickly. Essentially, it can record your actions and turn them into a button to automate the process for you next time. This may sound complicated, but if you've ever found yourself doing a long or repetitive set of steps to achieve a certain effect, then auto actions may help you save some time. For webcomic making, there are lots of great uses for auto actions that can make the process easier. To make one for yourself, the first step is to go to Window, Auto Action. Click the folder button next to the drop-down menu to create a new set. These are used for organizing your actions. Click on this button next to the trash can to create a new action. As you can see, once your action has been created, a red button will become available at the bottom of the window. Once you click this button, Clip Studio Paint will start recording every action you take. For now, I'm just going to tweak the colors of this page like I would normally. Once I've gotten my image looking how I like it, I can stop the recording with the red button again. By clicking the drop-down arrow next to the auto action, you can see exactly what steps Clip Studio Paint recorded and edit them if you accidentally included something you want to take out. For this example, I'm going to clear all the tweaks I just did on the image back to its default state so the results are clear. Now the magic happens. By clicking the play button, all the steps you previously recorded will be performed automatically by the program. So how is this useful? When you're making a webcomic, artists are aiming to have consistency between pages, so being able to quickly apply the same steps over and over is crucial to saving yourself time and effort. Now that I've made this color adjustment action, for example, I can apply it to all my pages and I wanted to try and match the colors up manually. There are a few auto actions I like to use often. My favorite is one I created for coloring line art. When I open up the toggles, you can see just how many steps this would take if I were to do it manually. But instead, I'm able to just click the play button while my line art layer is selected, and all that work is done for me instantly. From there, I like to go ahead and manually color in other parts of the line art, like I showed in my previous video about coloring. The possibilities with auto actions are endless if you get creative with it. If you want to play around with auto actions but don't know where to start, the Clip Studio Assets page has an entire section dedicated to popular auto actions made by other users. Many of these are helpful for both comics and illustration, so check them out if you're interested. I've posted my line art coloring auto action to my page, which is linked down below if you'd like to download it. Those are the basics of how you can use Clip Studio Paint's auto actions to help with making your webcomic. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.